Today, I'm going to show you how to set up a crayfish tank in 10 easy steps. We're going to start with an empty tank and work our way to a fully stocked running setup at the end. Step one is your tank location. Crayfish dislike strong sunlight and high temperatures, so it's important to build or position their tank accordingly. Somewhere that has semi-shade or where you can create shade for them is preferable. The second step is crayfish tank size. The crayfish tank that you can see behind me measures 4 meters long, 2 meters wide, and has a depth of about 70 centimeters. It's important to know the volume of your tank for the correct stocking levels. You should take into account the depth of water you intend to keep your crayfish in and extra height above the water level to prevent them from escaping. The third step is water. Crayfish do not need deep water to thrive. 5 to 8 inches is adequate, so don't overfill your tank. Use a simple overflow pipe to prevent too much water. Water quality and water temperature are critical to keeping your crayfish healthy. If you're using mains water, let it stand for at least 24 hours before adding your crayfish. Do not pump water from off your property unless you can ensure it's safe. The water may contain harmful chemicals. Use rainwater or, like us, pump from a borehole. The fourth step for your setup is hiding places. Make sure your crayfish have more than enough hiding places. This will reduce fighting and cannibalism during the molting process. Use pipes, plastic egg trays, plant pots and rocks. Make sure they're all well spaced apart to minimize fighting. Step five is adding aquatic plants. Adding aquatic plants to a crayfish tank setup serves several purposes. They provide additional hiding places, cover during daylight hours, and most plant species have edible parts such as their leaves, stalks, and roots. Take precautions when introducing plants from the wild. They could be contaminated or have potential predators hiding in their root systems. Step six is one of my personal favorites, water snails. Adding water snails to your tank setup helps in a couple of ways. Firstly, they eat algae, detritus, and uneaten food items. Secondly, crayfish absolutely love eating baby snails. We have thousands of baby apple snails hatch every month, and the adult crayfish eat every single one. They're a great source of additional protein and calcium for their diet. The seventh stage is stocking levels. Depending on the species, age, and gender of crayfish you're growing will impact on the correct stocking level. You also need to take into account the volume of the tank, not necessarily the square meters available. Remember to take into account the depth of water along with the structures and plants that you've added. It's all about the surface area available, not necessarily the square meters. Stage number eight is oxygenation. Adding oxygen to your crayfish tank setup is a great way of maintaining healthy water quality. Although crayfish can thrive in muddy, stagnant pools, adding a cheap and simple air pump will help to keep the water fresher for longer before having to carry out water changes and tank cleaning. Here on our farm, we grow crayfish with and without oxygenation, and both are equally as productive. Ninth on our list is filtration. Like oxygenation, installing a filter to your crayfish tank setup is down to you and your budget. There's no doubt that adding filtration keeps the tank's water cleaner for longer, but it's not required as long as you're willing to carry out tank cleaning more often. We currently don't run filters on any of our tanks because we prefer to drain everything down once a month to check for pregnant crayfish and remove any unplanned babies that have hatched. The 10th step on the list is water heaters. I've purposely left the water heater until last. That's because our farm here in the warm tropics of Thailand doesn't require them. Our Australian red claw crayfish breed for about 10 months of the year. If we want to extend that to all year round, then we'd run water heaters in the cooler months. Depending on where you're growing your crayfish, you may need to have heaters running all year round and increase the temperature during the coldest months. Right, it's time for me to go and check our hatching tanks, which is home to all our pregnant female crayfish. If you have any questions or would like us to cover a specific topic regarding growing crayfish, write a comment below. Or just say hello, where you're from, and what crayfish you're growing. We'd love it if you give us a like, but for now, here's some more crayfish videos for you to enjoy.